live aloof from learned men who keep their watch upon the stars so bright. Some say we're kooky or we're crazed, because into the sky we gaze to see what God might tell us through its light. They call us kings, but we are not. We're merely men who've learned a lot. And though we study science, we agree that God alone controls the sky, the sun and moon and stars on high. So why not try to guess who we might be? Wise men, astronomers, stargazers, magi, no matter what you call us, we're still wise guys. And when you think of the Christmas story, you can't help but think of us, especially Melchior, Gaspar, and Balthasar. But there were other wise guys who made the trip that first Christmas, as well as the cooks and camel boys who went with us. How do I know? I was there. And what a trip that was. It all started the night we saw that incredible star.
I've never seen such a star.
Is it a nova or several planets?
Hello? It must be a sign we've been waiting for.
Excuse me?
Yes, this star must announce its birth.
Sirs, I'm sorry to disturb you, Miss Bird. Are those alive, guys?
Boy! You must have rolled it on the back of a pomegranate cart. Of course they are. You're wise guys.
Don't mind Cookie, my boy. Now, how may we help you?
My name is Jesse, and I've traveled all the way from the West to become a wise guy.
I see. Well, I'm Melchior, and this is Gaspar and Balthasar. But I'm afraid you've come at a very bad time.
That's right, son. You see, we're leaving as quickly as possible to find the heavenly king.
Why else would God announce his birth with such a magnificent star if he weren't a king sent from heaven? Well, you wouldn't know about such things, and we really must be going.
But I do know, and you're right. Isaiah said, one, like the Son of Man, should come forth from the clouds of heaven. And Balaam said, a star shall come forth from Jacob.
What a goofy idea, like I'm sure with all the ways. God can tell us about a king. He's going to use some overblown star.
But a good better way for God to speak to stargazers than through a star. After all, that's our language.
Besides, I've always been taught that God doesn't think the way we think or do the things we would do, if I may say so.
stories about him all my life.
My dad heard them from his dad, who heard them from his dad, who heard them from his dad, who heard them from his dad.
Well, it's for sure we've heard enough.
You must be hungry, son. Cookie, can we feed this boy?
Sure. Today's menu is prune pit salad, wings of sparrow, and grasshopper juice.
Yum, yum.
Come on, Jesse.
Wait, wait. This king, do you know his name?
I know some of them.
You mean he has more than one?
Sure. Isaiah said, for unto us a child is born. Unto us a son is given. His name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
Gifts fit for a king.
But I don't even know his size. How do I know what fits him?
Some wise guy you make.
No, Jesse. Something fit for a king means something very valuable. Something chosen especially for him. Since he's the Prince of Peace, I'll bring him something suitable for a monarch.
You want to give him myrrh, Balthazar? That's for dead people.
got a point. Gold and frankincense are very good gifts. Myrrh?
Wait a minute. Both Isaiah and Zechariah said the king would give his life for us.
Sure. Everybody who believes that, stand on your head.
But he will. His love will be a love we've never known before. A sacrificial love.
Well, if that's true, then myrrh is an excellent gift.
Yes. Gold is for his royalty, frankincense is for his deity, and myrrh is for his sacrifice.
What did I tell you?
Camel?
Yes, sir.
Then you have the camel boy to saddle up and ready to go.
Yes, sir.
Cookie, do you have any other foods for us to take with us?
Certainly. Tomorrow's menu is donkey tail stew, boiled dust feet, and pickled cactus.
Yum, yum.
Splendid. Well, you and the cook get it packed up and ready to go. Well, I think the time has come, wise guys. Go west, wise guys. Go west.
What do you suggest we do?
Yeah.
any. But here's one Nomad is going to be so mad if we don't stop and eat.
I agree, Cookie. What have you got?
So glad you asked, Gaspar. Today's menu is goat brains over rice, fried salamanders, and bird feather tea.
Yum, yum!
All right, we'll make camp here for the night.
Melchior, how much farther do you think it'll be?
I don't know, Jesse, but I do know when we get there, it will be worth it.
Just imagine what it would be like to finally get to see the king.
To enter his stately palace.
To look upon his majestic throne.
To see his magnificent crown.
I can hardly wait.
Anxious to see this king myself.
Oh, Cookie, he'll be wonderful.
Of course he will. But remember, you're just cooks and camel boys. He's a king.
A heavenly king.
Which means you might not even get to see him.
Look, the star! It's back.
It's bigger and more beautiful than before.
We can't be far now. Come on.
Here we go again.
Yeah. town of Bethlehem.
See how still it lies?
Hold your camels, wise guys. How do you know that's where the king is?
She has a point. It looks awfully small for a king to be born.
He's right about that.
Terribly tiny.
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 Wait a minute. I remember now. Even though Bethlehem is small, Micah said out of it would come a ruler who would be the shepherd of his people.
Well, it still seems awfully small to me, but God is wiser than a wise man.
You mean we're almost there?
Yes, Cookie. After all this time, we're almost there.
Yay.
Yeah, yeah, right. Yeah. Tubular.
Just to
You're a truly wise man.
Don't just stand there. Come on.
We have gifts for Amasa.
Well, my gift isn't gold or frankincense or myrrh, but this bread I bake is about the best you'll ever taste.
She's a very good cook. I'm sure you'll like it.
I'm sure I will. And what is your gift, camel boy?
What can he possibly have that's fit for a king? I don't know.
Nor I.
Yes, take it from an old camel boy. After that first Christmas, nothing was the same. Tough cookies became tender-hearted faith walkers. Wise guys learned that God's wisdom is far above their own, and simple camel boys became wise men when they gave their lives to the heavenly King. At least this camel boy did. Would you like to become a wise guy? You can. Just take a trip with your heart to the manger and worship the King. Light, and so it continues.